Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. Have you ever found yourself in a position where you've been asked to present about your research, but because you struggle to find time to invest in creating a really good PowerPoint presentation, you've thought about turning down the presentation opportunity? I have, so to avoid this situation, I've created a simple process to create some really eye-catching presentations using Google's free artificial intelligence tool called Bard. And also by learning how to draw on some pretty powerful functionality built into Word and PowerPoint to create some really professional looking and engaging presentations. In this video, I'm going to share this process with you so you don't have to turn down any opportunities to share your research with others. Okay, so let's get started. So I've been asked to create a 30-minute presentation on this research paper that I've co-authored. So to quickly create a professional looking presentation, the first thing I'm going to do is use the Google Chrome web browser to go to the journal page where my research paper has been published and copy the URL address. Next, I'm going to go to Google's free artificial intelligence tool called Bard by typing in this address. I found that Bard is better than ChatGPT and Bing AI in undertaking these following tasks. So I would recommend that for the purposes of creating research-based presentations that you use Bard. Next, I'm going to type into Bard's prompt box, provide a list of slide titles based on the following research paper, and then I paste in the URL address. I want to use these slides to summarize a set of points from the research in my PowerPoint presentation. You can see that it's produced a great list, starting with an introduction exploring social media and social work, the use of Facebook in social work practice, and the research study. Then, and this is what I really like, it clearly draws quite accurately on the findings of the paper by outlining the three types of Facebook use we found and listing these behaviours as social workers actively searching, opposing any use, and being unwilling to use Facebook and therefore being drawn in. It then explores the reasons Facebook was used and the ethical implications and a discussion slide with some suggestions for additional slides I could include. I have to say, I do find this to be pretty impressive. If I wanted, I could think that this is a really great start and I could just go ahead into PowerPoint and start building on these slides by adding additional information myself, but that would actually require quite a lot of time and effort from me. So, let me show you how you can be a little more time efficient by using Bard to flesh out these slides a little bit more. So I'm going to say, can you repeat that, but this time include 2 to 4 dot points which provide a brief explanation about each slide. And you can see that Bard is pretty good at doing this, and it's provided a number of bullet points for what I could put on my PowerPoint presentation. And I have to admit, I'm pretty impressed with how accurate the information is so far. At this point, it's provided a good bare-bones approach that I could just use from this point to create my presentation. You could also, at this stage, get Bard to elaborate further by asking it to create additional slide titles and bullet points as you see fit. But actually, I'm quite happy with what it's produced so far, so I'm just going to carry on. And to be honest, I'm pretty sure that I could easily talk to these points in a 30-minute presentation without any problems. There is just one thing to be mindful of if you're using this approach, and that is that at this stage, before building your PowerPoint, I would suggest that you carry out a thorough check of the contents and make sure that all the information is correct before building your presentation. Okay, so I've checked the information and I'm happy with it. This is how I'm going to build my presentation. Firstly, I don't want to have to copy and paste all of this information one by one into PowerPoint, because that will take forever. And so what I do instead is click on these three dots here and copy the information from Bard. Then, with Word open, I'll click on the View menu, then Outline, and then paste the text into the page. I'll then get rid of the unwanted text at the top and bottom of the document that's been copied over from Bard. Looking at my text, I can see that the slide names are still there. These are the introduction, findings, discussion, and conclusion. I want to make sure that PowerPoint knows that these are the titles and the other text is for the body of the slides. And this is quite easy to do. All you have to do is select all the text, then move all the text to level 2. If I was to create the PowerPoint now, it would put all the text into the body of the slide, and we don't want that. So if I highlight the slide titles, I can move these onto level 1. This tells PowerPoint that these are the title slides. Once I've done this and I'm happy with the layout and content, I'll save the document as plain text. I'll give the document a name. I'll call it Research Text and save it into this folder. In PowerPoint, create a blank presentation, go to New Slide, and then go to Outline, and then locate the text that you saved before and click Insert. And here you'll see that you've got a title slide that you can complete later, but you also have the introduction, the text for the introduction, the findings, and so on. And at the moment, everything's a little bit all over the place, and so you can tidy this up by going to Designer. And what you can do is you can actually pick a slide from the Designer function. So I'm going to pick this one because I actually quite like the way that it looks. And so immediately you can see that it's given it quite a professional outlook. Then I'm going to click on the next slide, and I actually like this particular slide. So what it does is it kind of relates the content to the image a little bit. I'm going to move on to the next slide, and this time I'm going to pick a different type of slide. So I'm just going to click on this one, and I actually quite like the orange in the background, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually change this a little bit because I'd like it to have a different type of look. So I'm going to just click on this slide, and I actually quite like that because, again, I like the images and the way that it's actually been set in the slide itself. And as you can see, Designer actually generates design ideas. And all you have to do is just select on it, and it actually creates quite a nice way of presenting the findings. So I actually quite like this finding slide as well. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to very quickly just go through the presentation and select slides that I like the look of. And you can see that it's really quite easy and quite quick to do, to create a presentation that actually looks quite professional and quite engaging as well. I quite like this because you can see the links in the image in terms of the discussion. And so every page can be created to look a particular way. And it's up to you how you want to present this in terms of a style. You can choose a single style for everything, or you can choose a different style for each slide. And you can see how very quickly now I've created a presentation with an introduction and goes through each one of the three elements that I created through Bard, and it provides each heading and then each section of the information that was produced to explore the different elements. And I'd be quite happy actually to just use this presentation as it is to present my findings. And what it's done is it's created 14 slides. I can add a slide at the end, and I can put a title slide at the top. And so you can see that very, very quickly using the design element, you can produce some really professional looking slides. And so that's just a very quick example of how you can use PowerPoint and the designer element in PowerPoint to create some really professional looking slides. I hope that you found this video useful. Not having time to create professional and engaging presentations should not prevent you from sharing the important messages of your research within a wider community. If you ever find yourself in a situation where you have to create a PowerPoint quickly, I hope that these simple steps have helped. If you found this information helpful, please make sure you like the video and consider subscribing. That way I can make more videos that can show you ways you can use artificial intelligence more productively in order to make your research, teaching, and presenting life a little easier. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.